What's up, guys? Good afternoon. So, we are here in my video again about the journal entries. Let me repeat and repeat it again. So, you have to master the journal entries and the adjusting journal entries because those are the most difficult phases or steps in the accounting cycle. Now, this particular journal entries and adjusting journal entries, it demands you to analyze as opposed to following steps only or procedures in the other steps of the accounting cycle. So, what we are going to do this afternoon is to ask ChatGPT to become the quiz master of the multiple choice questions related to accounting transaction identification, debits and credits, journalizing transactions, and adjusting journal entries and key and history of accounting, history and overview of accounting. You have to give me one by one the multiple choice questions and let me answer first and give me the reason why am I wrong or correct before going to the next question. And of course, you have to make it very challenging for me. Okay, let's go. Question number one. Which of the following transactions would result in a debit to an expense account? So, payment of dividends to shareholders is what do we call the withdrawal in the corporation context. So, I know that we did not yet discuss about corporations. However, this is just equivalent to withdrawals in the sole proprietorship. So, it's not an expense account. It's a withdrawal. So, it's not letter A. So, letter B, purchasing office supplies on account. So, office supplies is basically an asset. So, since it is not used, so it is still an asset. It's not yet an expense account unless you're going to record the purchase of office supplies based on expense method, in which it was not emphasized here that you are to record those supplies using the expense method. So if the problem or if the question is silent, then you are to use the asset method of recording prepayments and office supplies. Okay, so accrued wages that will be paid on the next period. So again, these accrued wages, that it means, oh no, so it means that you have already used the services of your employees and that you are still to pay them in the next period. So, even if you are to pay them on the next period, according to the accrual concept, expenses are recognized when incurred. So the answer might be letter C. But mind you, you have to read all the multiple choices first before deciding on an answer. So for me, that's letter C, but I have to read the letter D. So collection of cash from a customer for services rendered in a previous period. No, it will not result to expenses. Okay? So it was recorded in the previous period as a revenue, and of course when you collect it, of course your receivable will just be decreased. So there is no relationship with the question, which is related to debiting an expense account. So my answer is letter C. So if I've explained it, so we're correct. So let's close this. Let's go to question number 2. So, which of the following adjusting entries correctly records the expiration of prepaid insurance? So, of course, if there is a prepaid insurance and we're talking about expiration of prepaid insurance and the expiration is the main point of the adjusting entry, that means the company or the accountant or we are using the asset method. Because under the asset method, we recognize the prepayments or advance payments as asset first. And then in the end, the adjusting entry will pertain to the expired portion of any prepayments or advance payments, right? So if that is the case, we're looking for the entries. Of course, that's debit insurance expense and then credit prepaid insurance. That's letter A. But then again, you have to read everything. So debit prepaid insurance, credit insurance expense. This is an adjusting entry if you are recording initially the prepayments or deferred expenses using expense method. And so that is not letter B, and we have letter C, cash credit insurance expense. It's weird that I have not seen anything like this, but supposedly if the insurance company will give you a reimbursement, this will happen. Debit cash, and then your insurance expense that you have paid will be credited because, again, the insurance expense returned something, okay? So, it's not still related to the question. And we have letter D, debit insurance expense, credit accounts payable. This is weird. That is not D. It's impossible that you will have insurance expense and then accounts payable. Because normally, the insurance companies collects in advance. So, this is not possible. Or, if it is possible, the probability of this happening is very small. So my answer is letter A. So let's have this type of test so that we'll be able to enhance our knowledge about adjusting entries and journal entries. Okay, so we have number 3. A company provides services to a customer on account. So you have already provided the services. Which of the following journal entries correctly records this transaction? So my answer is immediately letter A. That's accounts receivable, credit, service revenue. Because this is an accrued revenue wherein you have already delivered what you should be delivering. It could be services. It could be goods. In this case, this is services. And then you will have an asset, which is the accounts receivable increase, so debit, and then credit service revenues. So my answer is letter A. Although, again, you need to read all of the choices before deciding. But for me, to save time, I'll have letter A. Let's see if I'll be wrong later on. Now, let's go to question number 4. Question number 4. Which of the following transactions would require an adjusting entry at the end of the accounting period? Okay, so cash payment of rent in advance for the next 3 months. Yes, it will require an adjusting entry, but then again, you have to read all the choices. So a customer makes an advance payment for services to be provided next month. Okay, so maybe we have depreciation of office equipment. Yeah, maybe. Purchase of supplies for cash. Which of the following transactions would require an adjusting entry at the end of the period? So, I'm confused as to what will be the answer. Because company, a cash payment of rent in advance for the next 3 months could be. Customer makes an advance payment for services to be provided next month. Might be, but if you are going to use revenue method, then there will be no adjusting entry at the end of the month. The depreciation of office equipment is usually at the end of the accounting period. So, these two, A and B, there is a chance that there will be no adjusting entry at the end of the accounting period because maybe the company will be able to use, instead of asset method, will use expense method. So in the next 3 months, it will be consumed already. And the customer makes an advance payment for services to be provided next month. So what if the customer, oh no, what if the company is using revenue method? So there will be no adjusting entry. One thing that's sure, it's letter C for me. Depreciation is always an adjusting entry at the end. Okay? Explanation. Let's take a look at depreciation is a non-cash expense that allocates the cost of a fixed asset over its useful life. Since this allocation happens over time, an adjusting entry is required at the end of each of the accounting period. So, oh. So, this is correct, guys. Option A, cash payment of rent in advance records prepaid rent, which would only require adjustment if part of the prepaid rent has been used. So, it's not at the end always, if it is used only. And we have option B, advance payment from a customer involves an earned revenue which requires adjustment when the service is provided, not before. Okay. So, letter D. Purchase of supplies for cash is an immediate transaction. No adjusting entry needed unless there's year-end count revealing unused supplies. I agree. So, that's how you analyze multiple choice questions. So, which of the following is the correct journal entry for recording the sale of goods on credit, assuming perpetual inventory system is used? Although, we are not yet here. Okay? So, I'll just answer this because this is already on the merchandising part and we are still on the service entities, accounting for service entities. So, the journal entry in sale of goods on credit, assuming in perpetual inventory system is used, is debit accounts receivable and then credit sales revenue and then debit cost of goods sold and then credit inventory. That's letter B. Next. We have next. Which of the following correctly describes the purpose of trial balance? Although we are still not here. So let's try to answer. Maybe this is the last question that I'm going to answer. To verify that the company's financial statements are accurate. So again, the question is which of the following correctly describes the purpose of the trial balance to verify that the company's financial statements are accurate. Actually, even if the trial balance is balanced, you cannot be able to say that the company's financial statements are accurate because it might be balanced, but you have a wrong entry. So to check that total debits equal total credits in the ledger, that must be the answer. But let's read all the multiple choice questions. To provide a summary of company's financial performance, it's not. Because it's the financial performance is related to statement of comprehensive income. And to adjust entries that were posted incorrectly, no, it's not. So the correct answer is B for this one. Okay, so that's it for this video. So what will happen is that we're going to have a multiple choice question. The coverage will still be the same so that you'll be able to practice answering multiple choice questions instead of filling the blanks or analyzing using the A is equal to L plus C so that you'll be versatile. So that message is for my students and for those who are viewing this particular video, if you are an accountancy student, you need to practice also multiple choice questions, because in your tests or board exam in the future, it does not only involve open-ended questions and fill in the blanks, it also includes multiple choices. Okay? So that's my goal here. Again, reminders, when there is a multiple choice question, you have to consider all of the choices first before selecting an answer in order for you to get the best answer. Okay? So that's it. See you on the next video.